Good morning, friends. So today, now I'm going to discuss this Paget's disease of the breast, one of the important topic for exam, right? So topic is Paget's disease of the breast. So what is Paget's disease of the breast? So what we have to understand, it's not a very common entity. It's a very rare entity, right? It's very rare entity, and it will be seen only in 1 to 4% of the breast cancer. So only 1 to 4% of breast cancers are associated with Paget's disease, right? So usually Paget's disease is associated with invasive ductal carcinoma of the breast. So that is another important thing we have to understand. Ki Paget's disease, usually it's a rare one, and if it is present, it is usually associated with the invasive ductal type of breast carcinoma, right? So what happens in the Paget's disease of the breast? When we look at the Paget's disease of the breast, their clinical presentation, right? Their clinical presentation is usually associated with the gross morphology also, right? So what is the gross morphology? When you will see the patient, gross morphology means when you are examining clinical patient also, they will be having similar presentation. They'll be having correlating presentation with the gross morphology and the histological presentation. Now I will show you those things also, right? For example, when you are seeing the presentation, clinical presentation of the patient, they will be having pruritus in nipple areas, right? So pruritus of the nipple area associated with erythematous lesion with scaly crust, right? So there will be scaly crust, pruritus, erythematous lesion. So this will be presentation of the patient. When she will be presenting to you, she will be having pruritus, erythematous rash, and scaly crust over the nipple area, right? So this will be involving nipples, right? So when you are examining a nipple or surrounding areas of the nipple, they will be having pruritus, erythematous lesion, and scaly crust. This presentation will mimic like a eczema, right? So this will mimic like an eczema. So that is why sometimes Paget's disease is described as a eczematoid lesion. Eczematoid, not eczema. Eczema like. Why? How you are going to discriminate? Because they will be always similar to this, but how you are going to discriminate eczema versus Paget's disease of the breast? So it's easy to understand. Paget's disease of the breast will be unilateral. Eczema will be bilateral. So all these things will be bilateral in case of eczema. Paget's disease, it will be unilateral, right? So this is how we are going to discriminate on the clinical basis. This can be a Paget's disease of the breast, and this will be eczema, which will be bilateral pruritus erythematous lesion with scaly crust. So this is the clinical presentation of the patient which you are going to see. Now, as I said, this clinical presentation which you are seeing, it will be correlating to the microscopy or histological presentation also. So what will be the histology of this Paget's disease, right? In histology, when you will see the microscopic examination, of the Paget's disease, what you will notice that? What is the important characteristic which you have to notice in this case? Suppose I am showing you, this is the epidermis and this one is the basement membrane, right? Epidermis, basement membrane. So we are seeing epidermis, basement membrane, and underlying stromal tissue, and this is the ductal tissue, right? So this is the ductal tissue, and this is again the same thing, epidermis and the basement membrane. So this is the one important image which is easy to understand the concept of Paget's disease, why it is important. What is the specialty of this Paget's disease? Whenever you will see the tumor cells, now I'm going to show you this tumor cells which are inside the duct. See, what I'm going to show you, tumor cells are inside the duct. So this black tumor cells are inside the duct. These are the ductal carcinoma, right? So what I'm showing you, these are the tumor cells which are the representative of ductal carcinoma within the duct, right, within the duct. So what is the specialty? As I was telling you, what is the specialty of the Paget's disease? All these tumor cells will be spreading, and through the duct they are entering. Now they are going to enter inside the epidermis. Now these tumor cells, they will be passing through the intercellular gap, and now they are coming inside the epidermis. So what is the important thing we are noticing, that this basement membrane is not broken by the tumor cells. Means basement membrane is still intact. You can see basement membrane is intact. Tumor cells are originating from the duct and they are passing through the duct. They are entering into the epidermis without crossing the basement membrane. That is important point. See what I am saying? Without crossing basement membrane. So tumor cells are entering into the epidermis without crossing the basement membrane. That is the importance of the Paget's disease. So that is why I said Paget's disease will be having underlying invasive breast cancer, right? And that is why it will be having in underlying invasive breast carcinoma. So this tumor cells are coming up, they are infiltrating the epidermis, and when they are infiltrating the epidermis, what will happen? There are cells. These are the squamous cells of the epidermis, right? So these are the squamous cells of the epidermis. So when tumor cells will come, so now you can see that when tumor cells will enter, and now when they are coming between the squamous cell, because they are having tight junctions, because of this tight junctions will be broken up by tumor cells, and because of this breakdown between the two adjacent squamous cells, extracellular fluid, see what I am showing you here, extracellular fluid in yellow color, it will be leaking through this and they will be coming outside. So this extracellular fluid will be coming outside, and now they are making a scaly crust. That is why there will be scaly crust. So they are having erythematous lesion plus scaly crust. So what is the source of scaly crust? These are the extracellular fluid which is coming out between the epithelial brocade, and they are coming outside, and now they are forming the ECF, and this is ECF is known as scaly crust. So this is the reason for scaly crust. So that is how scaly crust will be formed, right? So that is the significance of the Paget's disease. Whenever we come across the Paget's disease of the patient, nipple will be having pruritus, erythematous lesion with scaly crust, which is suggestive of underlying breast cancer. Which breast cancer? Most commonly invasive ductal carcinoma of the breast. And now you can see how will be the nature of this cancer. This will be coming out, tumor cells are coming out, they are reaching into the epidermis, but without breaking down the basement membrane of the epidermis. That is the important, right? And when you will see the histological examination, when you will see microscopic examination of the individual tumor cells, how they will be looking like, you will be seeing normal cells. So these are the normal cells, right? These are the normal cells. How you are going to identify Paget's disease in your histological examination? Paget's cells are larger cells. So number one point, how will be the Paget's cells? They will be larger cells. So number one, larger cell. So Paget's cells, what I am writing here, how you are going to identify Paget's cell? So Paget's cell will be having characteristic feature, they will be large. So larger cell. And in this larger cell, now you can see the nucleus will be here. This is the nucleus, right? So larger cell, there is a nucleus, and this larger cell you will find abundant pale cytoplasm. Right, abundant pale cytoplasm, larger cell with abundant pale cytoplasm, and nucleus will be having prominent nucleoli. So what I am showing you, nucleus will be having prominent nucleoli, right? So larger cell with abundant pale cytoplasm and prominent nucleoli, this is the feature of the Paget cells. So one cell which is looking abnormally large in comparison to the normal surrounding cells, and inside the nucleus when you are seeing prominent eosinophilic nucleoli, that will be suggestive of the Paget cells, right? So whenever we see the histological examination, see, this is the gross picture. This is the gross examination of the patient, right? So when you are seeing gross picture of the patient, now you can see scaly erythematous lesion. Here you can see scaly erythematous lesion, which is the Paget's disease, right? And now you will see the microscopic examination, which I was telling you. In microscopic examination, you can notice here, right? In this biopsy, what we are observing, these are the normal cells. As I have told you, these are the normal cells which are looking smaller when you are comparing with these cells, larger one. You can see all these are larger cells. You can see these are the larger cells. And in these larger cells, you can see cytoplasm is very high in comparison to these cells, normal cells. Cytoplasm is more abundant, and you can notice they are having prominent nucleoli. You can see there is a prominent nucleoli. So, larger cell, abundant cytoplasm, which is looking pale also. If you compare, they are little bit faded away. So, that is described as a pale, abundant cytoplasm. And inside the nucleus, you can notice they are having prominent nucleoli. So, these are Paget cells, right? So, what I am showing you here, all these are Paget cells. So, this is how we are going to identify Paget cells. So, now we have seen the significance, even though it is rare, but significance is underlying invasive breast cancer. And another aspect, what will be the prognosis? What will be the prognosis of the Paget's disease of the breast? Right. So, when we are talking about prognosis of the Paget's disease of the breast, so that time we need to understand what will be IHC, what will be immunohistochemistry of the Paget's disease. So, when we are talking about immunohistochemistry of the Paget's disease, what we should remember that on IHC examination of the Paget's disease of the breast, they will be estrogen receptor negative, progesterone receptor negative, and they will be HER2 positive, right? So, by seeing this, you can easily make it out. HER2 positive, ERPR negative, so they will be having poorer prognosis. So, always remember, Paget's disease of the breast will be having poor prognosis, right? So, this topic is very important. Revise it, and you may see some question in your exam from this topic. My best wishes to everyone.